I am number one. It's a good fighter, but I am not focused now on my opponent. I focus on myself. I fight my game.
ก็ฟอร์มดีครับก็คู่ชกก็มีสไตล์การชกที่รวดเร็วครับเป็นคู่ชกที่น่ากลัวครับผม ครับผมก็จุดที่ได้เปรียบของผมก็น่าจะเรื่องประสบการณ์ในการชกมวยไทยครับกระดูกมวยไทยแล้วก็อาจจะมีการเดินบทเดินเบียดให้เอนาชิหมดเรี่ยวแรงหรือหนีหรือความเร็วของเอนาชิหนีไม่ออกครับ
I want to be the champion. I want to stay the champion. I want to stay number one. I see myself after that fight go back to my country, to my family, with my team, with my third belt.
และจะทำให้ผมมีชัยต่อเอนาชิครับ
Away from one championship fifth of Fury. It is a striking fan's dream card. It is going to be stacked tomorrow night, Friday night, from inside the Singapore Indoor Stadium. Michael Chiavello, Mitch Chilson with you for this Faceoffs program. We're about to see tomorrow night's athletes go toe to toe. Our main event tomorrow night for the ONE Super Series Flyweight Kickboxing World Title.See the defending champion, Ilias Ennahachi, put the gold on the line against the man they call the kicking machine, Superlek Kitamoo9. Mitch, any way you cut that main event, it is going to be epic.
Yeah, it's two really exciting athletes, both world champions, and they have such different styles. It is going to make for absolute fireworks tomorrow night.
Fireworks at our entire card here in Singapore tomorrow night from top to tail.We've got Rodtang, the Iron Man, the number one Muay Thai fighter on the planet, especially in that flyweight division against Tagir, Khalilov, Hiroki Akimoto versus Zhang Chenglong in a rematch, and also the return of Wonder Girl Vertex against Jackie Buntan. Mitch, what really stands out to you there? I mean, Giorgio Petrosyan on the card and Rodtang under the one roof one night. Are you serious?
These two really want to step up and prove why they are the best strikers in the world. They're both undefeated. They've never... You can barely even lay a glove on these guys. It is going to be so much fun to watch, but we've got a lot of really exciting battles.
I know right behind us, the athletes are getting ready for ONE Faceoffs.
Facing off first in a ONE Women's Atomweight Mixed Martial Arts Contest. Sunisa Thunderstorm Streisand of Thailand. And her opponent, Victoria the Prodigy Lee, representing Singapore and the United States of America.
No, folks, it's not world champion Angela Lee. It's her younger sister, 16-year-old high schooler Victoria Lee, the prodigy, making her mixed martial arts debut against a much more experienced 4-1 Sunisa Seeson. Seeson, who comes in for a career-high win over the veteran Rika Ishige last time out. Will Victoria live up to the hype? Wow, how about that? Our first glance of Victoria Lee in ONE Championship. Probably the most anticipated debut, certainly in ONE Championship history. Mitch, 16 years old. Will youth help or hinder Victoria Lee in a high-pressure situation?
Man, what were you doing at 16? I was barely learning how to drive a car, and this lady is driving into her debut in ONE Championship. But standing in front of her is Sunisa Seeson, a judo practitioner who's got serious ground skills. She's extremely aggressive, and she is ready to spoil the party for Victoria Lee.
Spoil the party indeed. That's the game plan for Sunisa Seeson. Victoria Lee says she takes out Seeson tomorrow night quickly. On their debuts, both her brother, world champion Christian, her sister, world champion Angela, ended their first debuts very quickly. And here they are side by side. Left of screen, there's Victoria. Right of screen, the world atomweight champion Angela Lee. So many similarities, but speaking to Angela a couple of days ago, she says Victoria does things even better than her.
You know, it's hard to believe, but these Lees just keep getting better and better. We expect Victoria Lee to come out and put the pedal to the metal and release that Lee aggression that we've seen in the past. Angela Lee got it done in one round. Christian Lee got it one round. I don't know, man. I cannot wait to see what happens tomorrow night.
Will the hype train be derailed, or will the prodigy come through?
Up next, in a one women's strawweight Muay Thai contest. Jackie Bunton, representing the United States of America. And her opponent, Wonder Girl Vertex of Thailand.
Really looking forward to this one. It is a strawweight Muay Thai contest. If you haven't seen Wonder Girl Vertex before, you are in for an absolute treat. She is sharp. She is fast. She is powerful. Like her training partner, Stan Vertex, she is an entertainer. But taking on Jackie Bunton, training partner of world champion Janet Todd. Janet Todd, who beat Stan Vertex. Mitch, this one has a classic match written all over it.
It's really interesting because Jackie has been there every step of the way for Janet Todd. She's been in the training camp. She's actually been to her first match when Janet Todd made her debut. Jackie Bunton is extremely well-rounded, and she possesses all the skills to really put on a tremendous performance tomorrow.
She will need to bring all those skills to the fore in the circle here in Singapore tomorrow night, because against Wonder Girl, it's a very hard problem to solve. And you see the comments there from Janet Todd, her training partner, on social media. Wonder Girl brings so many weapons, Mitch. We know she has knockout power, but what I really love about Wonder Girl is her precision. With timing and precision like that, she shouldn't be Thai, she should be Swiss.
She's incredibly accurate, Michael. You're right. She can actually zero in on her target, and once she starts to unload, here she is getting it done against Brooke Farrell. She realizes the power that she possesses, and she really wants to display it. And she's also incredibly innovative, and because she has sort of a unique style that a lot of the girls, they like to keep their distance. They like to play the game. But no, Wonder Girl comes right out of the gates, and she really starts to flex on these people.
Look out for the knees, look out for the elbows on Wonder Girl Fairchex.
And now, in a one bantamweight kickboxing contest, Muay Thai boy, Zhang Chenglong of China. And his opponent, Hiroki Akimoto of Japan.
Traditional rivals throw down, China versus Japan, a rematch we've been waiting for, one Super Series kickboxing bantamweight bout. Mitch, tell us about last time the two of them met.
It was a really close back and forth battle. At the end of the match, both these guys really believed they did enough to capture the victory. And now we get to finally settle the score and jump right into round four. It's really interesting, these two, when they match up.
Mitch, when you do look at both of them, who do you give the edge to in power? Who do you give the edge to in positioning and range?
I don't know. At first glance, you would have to give the power to Zhang Chenglong because he hits with such thunderous shots when it comes to those hands. Here he is putting it on Akimoto. In the first match, it was Zhang Chenglong going first. He was initiating these strikes. He believed in his heart of hearts that he did enough to capture the victory. He was extremely aggressive, but in the end, it was given to Akimoto.
I'll tell you what, folks, on a card that features Rodtang and Petrosyan and Ennahachi and Superlek, this one between Akimoto and Zhang Chenglong is maybe flying under the radar, but I'm telling you, it could be the show still of tomorrow night.
You know, the power that Akimoto possesses is there too because of that right kick. He has got some thunderous thighs, and his legs deliver some extremely accurate shots. He can go to your legs, your body, and your head with that right kick, and I believe from the interviews that we had all this week, that's the weapon he wants to really utilize in this rematch.
Speaking of weapons, the man in our next matchup is a human weapon.
Coming on stage now in a one flyweight kickboxing contest, Tagir, Khalilov of Russia. And his opponent, Rodtang, the Iron Man, Jitmuangnon from Thailand.
The world Muay Thai champion, Rodtang, who for many is the number one Muay Thai fighter on the planet. For number one showmanship, number one excitement, now ventures into the kickboxing realm, looking to become a two-sport world champion. He wants the winner of Ennahachi and Superlek Kitamoo9. It starts tomorrow night against Tagir Khalilov.
And you can see from Rod Tank's t-shirt, he's flexing the mixed martial arts. He wants to go into all three sports. But tomorrow night, he's got a very tough test in front of him against Khalilov. Khalilov is extremely well-rounded. This kid is an absolute entertainer, and he knows that this is his opportunity being thrust into the spotlight, and he wants to make the most of it.
Mitch, I've got to say, Rodtang in kickboxing should not be too handicapped because his Muay Thai style is very kickboxing friendly.
You know, we've seen this consistently out of Rodtang. He has that Muay Mat style where he likes to put punches together in bunches and then punctuate every single combination with those heavy leg kicks. So his Muay Thai style just adapts perfectly to the kickboxing rule set. I think we're going to see a tremendous matchup.
A lot of people are saying Rodtang rolls through Khalilov in one round, but do not sleep on the Russian Tagir Khalilov. An upset is what he's going after.
Next up, in a one featherweight kickboxing contest, please welcome Davit Kiria of Georgia. And his opponent, Giorgio the Doctor Petrosyan from Italy.
This one a rematch some, what is it, 9-10 years in the making. Petrosyan last time beat Kiria in Rome. Now Kiria finally gets a shot at vengeance against the man universally regarded as pound for pound the finest kickboxer on the planet, the greatest kickboxer of all time. Petrosyan on this amazing winning streak. Flawless technique, untouchable. How do you solve the riddle here, Dragon?
You know, for years, Davit Kiria believed that all he needed was an extra 3 minutes and he would have figured out that puzzle that is Petrosyan. But in that instance, he has a full 9 minutes extra to try to figure out this problem because Petrosyan is just something else.
I tell you what, Kiria had better done his homework over those last 9 or 10 years because Petrosyan has improved since then, and I think Petrosyan handled him when they fought in Rome many moons ago. Petrosyan has become a lot stronger since joining ONE Super Series. We saw it especially with that knockdown, that knockout of Smoke and Joe Nutterwhite in, what was it, the first round. I mean, Petrosyan is a whole different beast than what we saw back in 2012.
The thing that I love about Petrosyan is his willingness to adapt to new styles. His opponents have so much footage on him, and they've seen him compete for so many years. And now, we're seeing a new Petrosyan. He is starting to go forward, and he's developing more power, which is truly shocking.
He's nasty now. Petrosyan is genuinely nasty in 2021. Still with those subtleties and nuances that make him the all-time greatest.
And now, we have come to the main event for the ONE Flyweight Kickboxing World Championship. Up first is the challenger, Superlek, the kickboxing machine, Jitmuangnon, representing Thailand. And now, please welcome the reigning and defending ONE Flyweight Kickboxing World Champion, Ilias, Ennahachi of the Netherlands and Morocco.
The champion Ennahachi looking lean and mean. And the man they call the kicking machine. I'm a poet, I don't even know it. Superlek Kitamoo9. That right leg of Superlek, when he opens up with it, Mitch, to the body, to the legs, it is unstoppable. Here's a guy that doesn't, like you see in those training videos where they're kicking the heavy pad, just 13, 14, 15 in a row. I mean, look at his previous matches. We've seen him go past 10, 11, 12 kicks. Just keep going.
Yeah, his right leg is an absolute baseball bat, and it comes with such precision and timing and speed, but that speed creates power. Have you ever seen those kids solve those Rubik's Cube?
Oh, yeah.
Like, they start to figure out. Yeah. That's what he looks like. As a match goes further and deeper, he starts to figure out the puzzle that's presented in front of him, and he just starts to unload once he has that problem solved.
I know Superlek says he's going to use his Muay Thai experience against Ennahachi, but I think that could be dangerous, because Superlek's Muay Thai moves him to these clinch positions that he won't be able to use under kickboxing rules. Ennahachi may exploit that. We know that Ennahachi can throw those high kicks from inside a phone booth.
But that's the thing. Superlek can also do it from distance, but he's going to have to deal with this. He's going to have to deal with this constant pressure. Look at these angles that he's cutting. He moves from side to side, forward and back, just seamlessly. And it comes with a flurry of punches to go on top of it. It is an absolute tornado of violence that is coming at you. And I cannot wait to see what happens when these two throw down, because ooh, it's an interesting contrast of style.
A tornado is the perfect way to describe Ennahachi, especially those hooks on the front foot, on the offense, also leaning back, the beautiful check hooks that he uses. The champion can do it all. A real contrast of styles in that main event tomorrow night, Ennahachi versus Superlek Kitamoo9. The ONE Flyweight Kickboxing World Title main event. Once again, the champion Ennahachi, the number two ranked multi-time Muay Thai world champion, who says out of all the world titles he has won throughout his illustrious Muay Thai career, to become the ONE Super Series kickboxing world champion would be his greatest moment. Folks, I hope you can join us. We are just over 24 hours away here in Singapore. Friday night, it's going down. ONE Championship Fist of Fury. Michael Schiavello, Mitch Gilson. We'll see you tomorrow night.